Hi everyone, my name is Haley Talbot and I'm a fourth year student at the University of Iowa. I work for University of Iowa Healthcare STEM Education, and today we're going to do a science experiment where we learn about liquid density.
You will need a few supplies to do this experiment along with me. You'll need vegetable oil, water, and then a heavy liquid. This could be honey, corn syrup, molasses. In our case, we're using Elmer's school glue. You'll also need 3 cups or jars to put your liquids in, and then a larger jar or cup to mix them in together. The next few items are optional for this experiment, and you can definitely do it without them. But we're going to use food coloring to dye our separate liquids, and then we have some household items that we're going to use for a later part of the experiment. The first thing we're going to do is fill up our cups with the vegetable oil, heavy liquid, and water. If you decided to add food coloring to your experiment, you can go ahead and mix that in now. You could do all layers the same color, or you could mix it up and do each layer a different color. That's up to you. What is liquid density anyway? In an equation, density equals mass divided by volume. Different liquids have different densities based on their weight or how many particles are inside each liquid. For example, our cup of glue weighs a little more than our cup of oil. Liquids with higher densities are heavier and will sink to the bottom, and liquids with lower densities are lighter and will rise to the top. Before we mix our 3 liquid layers together, something a scientist would do is create a hypothesis. A hypothesis is an educated guess about what you think is going to happen during your experiment. So what do you think will happen? Will our liquids mix together? Will they separate? Write down your hypothesis now before we test out the experiment. Now it's time to combine our 3 liquids into 1 larger jar. You can pour them in any order you'd like, but I'm going to do the water first, then my heavy liquid, and then the oil. Once your liquids settle, you should see your heavy liquid at the bottom, the water in the middle, and the oil at the very top. Were your predictions correct? Take a second to write down your experiment results. Now we're going to compare liquid density to the density of solid items by dropping various household items into our liquids. Can you predict which layer each one will stop in? Let's make a hypothesis about which density level you think each solid object will be sustained or stuck in when we drop them into the liquids. We tested ours out with a pop tab. Coin, a paperclip, and a plastic bottle lid. We can see that the plastic bottle lid stayed in the top oil layer, the paperclip and pop tab stayed in the middle water layer, and the coin sunk all the way to the bottom of the heavy liquid layer. Don't forget to record your results!
Now that you know a little bit about liquid density, you're 1 step further on your journey as a scientist. Keep experimenting!